goes down. He's slow in getting up. He throws his fist into the face of Murphy. Chassé seems to be a bit frustrated. Now the linesman trying to get there. Chassé and Murphy. Now we got a fight. Pronger and Carney. Main event. Oh, rolling. Third man in. Now here comes Fuhr and Courtnall. Fourth and fifth man in. Roenick jumping Pronger, who was involved in a fight at center ice with Keith Carney. Oh, baby, it's happening now with 3:34 to go. And LaPerriere in a headlock with Probert and one of his teammates over to look after LaPerriere. Pronger getting into it with Carney, and for some reason, Roenick came flying into the pile as if Keith Carney needed some help.
And we're not close to getting this thing straightened out yet. The pile of players down along the glass. Chassé is there. LaPerriere is there. Probert is trying to get at someone. Al MacInnis is trying to break things up. I'm not sure it's going to get broken up right away.
Now the linesman will come over. Roenick has gone to the dressing room. So has Pronger. And this is where a referee like Kerry Fraser really takes charge. Some referees in situations like this watch. Frazier and the veterans, the real good referees, seem to go around and say, okay, you do this, you do that. They tell people what to do. It tends to be calming, I think. And he's right over there now in what is, as you clearly point out, a very dangerous situation. And he's gone right into the middle of it. And I think, you know, he's like a good policeman. He directs traffic and makes things happen. And he's gone over there to help the linesman. And I think it's... strong again on the part of Kerry Fraser.
Yeah, you make an excellent point. Now, what Chassé is incensed about, he and Probert have run into each other a couple of times tonight, but as Probert came out of the penalty box and started skating towards the blue zone, the puck came over, there was a collision. Chassé.
Whoa! Probert and Chassé, main event! Probert and Chassé. Probert, one of the all-time great heavyweights, and they're going to let him go. Chassé has his hands full. They go from center ice to the near boards. Probert and Chassé. Chassé holding on, gets Probert's sweater over his head. Chassé not able to get in a position to swing. Now Courtnall going in. He's grabbed by Kerry Fraser. Fraser grabs Courtnall. Now everybody on the ice is in it again. And Carney jumps Chassé from behind. And look at Kerry Fraser. He barks at Carney. Oh, and off to the side, Murphy pins down, I believe, LaPerriere. And we've got a rugged situation. Kerry Fraser grabs Carney, and he's going to take him off the ice. Oh, baby, what a mess here. Very late in a somewhat one-sided hockey game. Now Probert, with his sweater in his hand, will be escorted off. There are sticks and gloves strewn around the ice here. And they've gotten Probert down the runway, still down near the Chicago goal. They've got some players involved, and Kerry Fraser over there. Well, I'll tell you, if Kerry Fraser has to take every player off the ice single-handedly, he's going to do it. He is a referee that's very, very active.
He's going to try.
Now the
Hawks players are upset. Apparently a fan threw something at Bob Probert, and that's a problem over by the Chicago runway.
Well, you can...
Roenick jumped in as the third man. This is where it started, and Roenick was in the middle of that.
Chassé took an elbow, and he was looking for anyone.
Yeah, that's
went
exactly
in after
right.
Murphy. He was just looking. He didn't even attempt to pick up his stick.
And
Probert came over.
Kerry Fraser was immediately going to call a penalty on Chassé.
That's right.
And then, well, now there'll be so many penalties, we'll never be able to count them. Here.
Well, after they thought they had things straightened out somewhat, Chassé is still out there. He's looking around. Probert comes over, and away they go.
That was a pretty good fight. Chassé
You know, anybody taking on Probert is going to have a tough time. And Denny Chassé, game and battling, but it's just hard for you to get in a position where you might get a swing at him.
Yeah, now Chassé hasn't fought Probert before because, remember, last year was Denny Chassé's first year in the league. Probert missed all of last year. I'm sure he didn't realize that Probert doesn't tie down his sweater. And so it easily comes off, and he lets it come off because his arms stay loose. So I think he was probably a little surprised by that, and maybe a little bit surprised.
Well, Roenick will be ejected as a third man in an altercation.
Now the Hawk penalty is over, and both teams are at full strength. Now here's Murphy getting a faceful elbow from Chassé, who had been knocked down by Probert. He didn't want to go at Probert. He gives Murphy a faceful elbow. Now we got a fight on the other side as Pronger is unloading on Carney. Roenick comes to tackle Pronger. And now Carney and Porto. Now Fuhr comes out of the net. He doesn't get involved, though. Belfour was ready to join the fracas as well. Just coming out of the penalty box, Roenick and Probert sandwiched Chassé. Didn't do anything to either one of them. He went at Murphy and elbowed him right in the face to start a fight. And then there were a couple of other skirmishes as well as Pronger took advantage of Carney, who is not very familiar with that situation, and he won that altercation handily. And then Roenick is going to be ruled a third man in here, it looks like.
That's a good play.
He got to. He had to.
Excellent play on Roenick's part. Here's a guy who needs another goal for a hat trick, and he takes off to help his teammate, who was in big trouble. Pronger was just teeing off on him.
Now Chassé gets hit by the two Hawks, Probert and Roenick. Doesn't do anything to them. Goes right at Murphy.
That was going to be the first penalty. Chassé was going to get a penalty. And somehow Pronger got clipped in the nose in that fracas. The stick came up and he went after Keith Carney and started flailing away on him. Will be ejected as a third man in an altercation. With 3 minutes and 34 seconds to go. Good play on Roenick.
Oh, here we go. Now Probert just grabs Chassé, and here they go at center right. Probert and Chassé slugging it out. Probert landed a couple of bombs early. Chassé trying to answer. Now they wrestle to the boards. And Chassé
holding on.
He tried to run, but he couldn't hide from the Hawk winger, Probert, who delivered the first hit. Now Courtnall wants to get in there, and the referee, Frazier, trying to keep the Blues from Probert, and he's not going to be able to do it. He's just outnumbered, and we're going to have more problems here. They're right along the near board. Everybody wrestling away, and some punching being done. Murphy and LaPerriere have hit the deck. And Gary Frazier's taking Carney out of the mess. Now Chassé, everybody else is separated. Except for a couple guys down in the corner. The Perrier and Murphy matched up. McGinnis and Weinrich wrestling.
This is all you, Frazier!
Game. Now there's been a problem behind the Hawk bench. Somebody must have thrown something down near the players. And many of the Hawk players trying to point to the culprit. Or the number of folks who might have been involved. And I don't see any security in that area at the moment.
To go. There was Chassé. Chassé exactly. He was going to get the first penalty and then reluctant to go at Probert, who knocked him down originally. And then he went at Murphy. And then Probert came in. And then Pronger was seen off on Carney. Roenick jumped in, was ejected at the third man. And then Probert got away and went after Chassé and then hammered him pretty well. And then now it's going to be a messy situation in the, with the fans here, many Blackhawk fans here. Chassé wouldn't let go. He was holding on. And
just now are a couple of security people reaching the area of the Hawk bench, being told who was...
You know, well, it doesn't make any sense for them to be down by the bench. They should be up in the seats. Players aren't going to do anything.
Well, that's right, but they came down to ask. There have been no security at all until just now that reached that area. They, wherever they were, I have no idea, but they're just now being informed as to who was throwing the garbage at the Hawk players. And so it'll take a while for all this mess to be sorted out. Elsewhere, there was a fight or two involving some fans, and so some of those goofs are being led.